Think we're live? Yes, it looks like it. Hello, everyone. Happy, let's see, Wednesday? I think I've got the day right. Anyway, welcome to the product launch group here. And I'm Terry Stevenson, your training and support specialist here at Product Launch. And I'm excited to be with you. I'm really looking forward to this little break in my day. I've been highly focused on several of my projects. This is going, you know, this is kind of like a, oh, now I get to go live and be with all of you and have some fun. So I want to make sure that I'm broadcasting. Yes, it looks like I'm broadcasting live. All right. Now, if you were with me yesterday and let's see, Monday, I was telling you what I'm working on is just kind of like fun. It's just a fun little project here where we can explore some of the tools and the way I approach some of the building and design aspects, because I'm building a digital vision board for myself. And I thought that might be something useful for you as well. And today, what I want to cover is we're going to jump into Cheetah and take a look at all of the different options that we have for galleries. You know, that's something I've never done in a live. We've never really focused on galleries to see what the Cheetah Builder has to offer. And this is the perfect time to do that because I've got lots of images I want to put into my vision board. And we have lots of different options in the Cheetah Builder. So that's what we're going to do for the next few minutes. We're going to hop back in to Cheetah and take a look and see what we can do with galleries with Cheetah. So I'm going to share my screen. Let's see. And we'll go over here. I'm going to go ahead and pop this up full blown so you can see the entire screen. And I'm back here and we can go right into Cheetah. Let me go into Cheetah because we could do this in the site. Let's see. Let's give it a chance to open here. And we were working on this site. These are the pages that we built. And yesterday we created that global header for those pages. But we could also do this in a playground. You know, it's just as easy. And I wanted to mention that because I hope I haven't for a while. I hope, let me flip this on just so you can see. I really hope you have created a playground, because if you're brand new to Builderall and you're just learning the software, this is a great way to learn how to use and experiment with some of the elements and how to build. If you set up a playground, a test site, and I have several, if you look through, this is just my training site too. And I have several that are mainly just sites for training. They're mainly Builderall playground sites, where I know I can go in there and make those changes and learn how it all works together. And I don't have to worry about messing up or making mistakes or having to correct something that I want to actually publish and use for my business or someone else's business. So definitely, if you haven't created a playground yet, get back in there, create a site, name it Playground or whatever you want. I have several. And then go back in there and use that site for experimenting. Now, we created this My Vision site with the pages in it. And since it's just going to be a page that I'm going to be accessing at this point, well, along with all of you, you're going to see it. I'll just go back in there and do my experimenting, and we'll do our exploring in the regular page. So I just wanted to drop that idea about the playground in this training, because if you haven't done that yet or you're brand new, That's really a good thing to do. Get your playground up and running. Now, let's go back into my vision. So edit the site. And I'm just going to pull up the people site. I know I'm going to have lots of images on this site. So we'll pull up that page. And remember, we have global headers assigned to this page. So we're not going to see the header inside of the editor. We will see it when it's published, but we won't see it inside of the editor. The editor. I can't remember whether you see it in the preview stage. I think you do. Let's check it out. Go to preview. I'm not sure whether it's, yes, it publishes. This is how it would look live. And we do have our global header right there on that page. So let's go back to the editor. And here you can see we haven't even added a panel yet. So that's the first thing we're going to do. I'm going to pop open my right menu. Come on, there we go. And I'm going to add a panel. I'm just going to add a blank panel. And for right now, I'm just going to make it a little bit longer, a lot longer. And let's see, this is the people page. This won't be the text that I keep, but I'm just going to go ahead and put some text in there so I know what I'm looking at when I just glance at it. So let's see, people. I want to meet. So now we've got some kind of a title. That's all we're going to worry about today. So if this is going to be a place, and let's explore some of these galleries and options that we have in Builderall for images. So we're going to add an element. We're going to scroll down here till we find the category of galleries and open it up. And you can see we have lots of options that are already created. We've got a template created. So it's a good idea to become familiar with what you have so you can know what your limits are and what you can do to create. I'm going to check over here. Hopefully, come on, mouse. There we go. Just want to. Hi, Linwood. I wanted to check the chat. How are you today? It's good having you here. All right, so we're going to come back over here and let's just pull in this top one. This is a very basic gallery, and all you have to do is select it and drag it over to your panel and drop it. And you can see this is just a basic slider panel. And if we can drop it anywhere on the panel that we want. We have a basic menu, editor menu up here. The same things that we have, save element, edit element, you know, layering, centering, all of these things, duplication, make it invisible, and of course your trash. So now let's explore and see how this particular gallery works. You can see that it's a slider pretty much. And if we open up the settings, we can have an auto play time. We can adjust it here. And we can also click this to turn off the auto play. And just operate it with the menu, with the arrows. Here we have the arrow, and that removes the arrows. Perhaps you want this playing as an automatic slider and it just repeating, and you want the sequence to remain the same and take that ability to move past in images out of the control of your users. You could deselect those arrows. Of course, all of your different customization of these elements, like your color, we can change that. and see what happens. There's the arrow color, and you see it's transparent there. I think we're going to go back. Let's do something like that. You can change the size, however, whatever suits your fancy. Now, here's the size of your element. So let's see if we can make it a little wider and a little higher. See, that's how much, how you can control it there. Including, of course, the minimum size. We have all these typical settings that you're going to find throughout all of your elements. So I'm not going to go, we've got lots of galleries to see. I don't want to go through each one of these. But this slider, let me come down here and pull open the animation part, because that's always something that you would like. You can also click and make it a timed animation when to start it and an effect. Now that's true of the text or any element. That wasn't exactly what I was looking for though. It's been a while since I've been back in here. Now let's add an image. You can see right here, we just have, I don't know how many. I think it's just one image there. So let's find the background. It's been a while since I've done this. You're going to see how easy it is. And let's see. Wait a minute. Look at my I can see. Apply. Where is it? Size. Let's just add an image. Okay, so here's, oh, it's got four, that's right. You have to, it's got four images in it. So we're going to take this image and we're going to delete it and delete it. Let's just delete all of these because I want to add them, my images. So let's add an image now. I'm going to go ahead and add all of the images that I had set aside and that I pulled for my people that I want to meet. And these are just collections that I have. Let's see, where is that? I'm not sure where I know that they're in my downloads. So we're going to upload all of these at once. Let's do Cliff and Colette and Byron and Eileen and Sharon, and let's just get some of these people. Well, that's a good start. We'll add those images. So I've got all of those in my repository now. So we're going to add Byron Katie. And save it. Now I can delete this one. So we're going to add another image and we'll add some more. We've got Cliff. And we're going to add another image. Eileen McCusick. And how about Dr. Joe Dispenza? And we're going to add Sherry Edwards. We're going to add, I've got more in my list. These are just the ones that I can find really fast. David Martin. Maybe it'll make you curious about some of the people that I find fascinating. And Colette O'Neill in Ireland. And let's just go ahead and save that. Now you can see that what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to adjust your images to fit the properties of your gallery. So keep that in mind, because this is something that, and I just really grabbed images. I didn't really do any kind of formatting or anything like that. And I did that on purpose because I wanted you to see how, you know, you can start with images, but you're not necessarily going to be able, you're going to have to do some editing to get them to look right inside of the gallery. Now let's just go ahead and save this because I'm going to just save it right now. And we're going to head over to see what this looks like in the preview. Now, this is the way that you need to explore and figure out what things look like. You can see that these images are all way too big for this gallery. So I would want to make them smaller, and it's going to refine. And I just pulled these off of, you know, the internet really quick. But you're going to want to make sure that the, depending on how big your gallery is, you're going to want to make sure your images are clear and that they're the proper size so they look right in the gallery. All of these images should be kept to a certain proportion so they appear right in the gallery itself. So you can get really creative that way too. All right, let's go back to the editor because this is just a typical slider. And I'm not going to go into, you know, like editing. Like we can even, you can play around with things and see how they look when you change the proportions of the slider. Let's see what that looks like, just out of curiosity. And we'll go back into preview. Oops, I'm getting too fast. I'm getting trigger happy. Now let's see what happens when this, see, that is even a little bit better. So you have to be willing to play around with it. Now you see, I didn't even get Dr. Joe in that one, but that looks halfway decent for that. And I cut Dr. Martin off and no clut. So as you're choosing your images and how you want them to appear, you're going to want to keep in mind what kind of gallery you want it formatted for. So it's really a good idea to start with the galleries, and that's why I wanted to cover how the different galleries look different. So let's go ahead and, let's go ahead and get rid of this one. We'll just get rid of this one, right? Oh, got to go back to the editor. This is always a process of just trying it out. And that's how you're going to understand what you need to, how you want to refine your images. So let's try a different gallery. Let's just pull in this one right here. So we're going to just pull it in and see what kind of a gallery it is. And it looks a lot different. It has pages that you click on here. You can see it's an image gallery, and we can make it larger for right now. Let's do that. And let's go ahead and put some images in there so we can see what how it compares. And let's see. Now, here's our images. Go up to settings. So we're just going to get rid of these and replace them with those images that we put in the other. There's some beautiful images in these galleries though. Oh, that's right, I have to have two. So because of the kind of gallery it's in there, it's going to force me to at least have two in the gallery before I can display it. So you have to put your images in and then remove the ones that are in there by default. So let's add some images. Just go back down here and add that one. And Cliff again. And I'm going to add at least four. Let's go ahead and add the others because I want you to see what happens when. Did I add Sherry? Oh, look. No, I didn't. So we'll add Sherry Edwards. And we'll add that thumbnail of Colette. Now, interestingly, I want you to see that. I'm going to remove this one, and we're going to remove this one. And you can see we have an odd number of images here. So it's going to look, I want you to see what's going to happen when we try to use this in the gallery. And let's go ahead and save it. And save it. And now let's go back into preview. So here's a gallery, and it doesn't automate, but you see we have that missing space. So if you're using this gallery, I personally think you definitely want to have the even number of images there. Even if it's an image that has text on it. Keep that in mind when you're looking at these as well. An image can be a graphic that is just conveying information. So let's go back into the editor and let's change the size of this a bit and see what happens. And we can... Let's see. We're going to lose our resolution because I'm making it bigger, and I do want to see if I can get at least Eileen's face there. Just kind of playing around right now. So let's go ahead and go into preview. And here's the gallery. Now, if we go to the second page, well, at least I've got everybody's face in there. And you can see this is more static at this point, but it certainly is a great way to deliver information, especially if you have four distinct messages or four separate or a balance here. If what you're trying to convey, like you could have an image, a photo in one place and a text in, you know, all three or opposite, you know, like an image with text and maybe an image here with text on the left. And then when your viewer is looking at it, they're getting an entirely different design feel for the page. That's what I want you to understand. Have some fun and allow yourself the freedom to have, you know, an image in your gallery that is graphic. Maybe it has an image on it, but it also has graphic. Or you could have just the text graphic, and you can mix it up that way and really showcase an entirely different page that way. So. All right, let's go back to the editor. We're going to go ahead and remove this one. Put it down so I can get to that trash. We'll delete it. Let's see what else we have in our gallery. Let's see what the difference is in this one. I can't remember. I think it's just the delivery of the buttons, if I'm not mistaken. See, the buttons are far different. So it's a different style of button. But you would do the same thing. All right, so... And here, I just noticed that. Here, we can switch to different images this way, different size images. We can go with tiles. We can go with a mix. And then we can also deliver it with just one main. That's the different themes. And how many images per page? We can change that anytime we want. We could just do 3 images and always, let's go to, and it keeps that last frame open. There's only 2 images, so kind of chose it. So these are just different options that you can consider. Because I can imagine even putting text here, or perhaps allowing an image, making the background transparent, allowing the background image to show through here in a very unique way. There's all kinds of ways to adjust these galleries. You can do the images per page, and you can also do columns. Here's one with 3 columns or 4 columns. But keep in mind, every time you adjust these, you're going to also have to adjust the vertical margins and the horizontal margins. Another unique feature worth mentioning that is great to play around with is the opacity. So you can just make it barely there. So that would be an interesting effect depending on what you have on the panel below it. I might play around with that idea using the single image, the top one with the slider, where that ghost, you know, that transparent image is changing and flipping through some images. That might be fun to play around with. So don't be afraid to play around with those as well. Now let's continue down here, because it's important that you really look at all of these different options that are available on all of your galleries. You have your navigation. This is how you can style the navigation elements. And this one shows it really clearly because you have these alternatives here of choosing the background color of your little button icons, as well as the hover color and the live color. So all of these settings are available too. Do you want the navigation with a number? Not necessarily. So you can do that. It's just up to you. And again, the minimum size is always important when you're especially looking on different devices, especially on mobile. So you want to make sure that your images look good on both scenarios on desktop and mobile. And sometimes that can really alter the way a gallery looks, of course. With less geography available on a mobile device, you're going to want to really choose your gallery wisely. In fact, I probably would just leave a single image and use the single slider on a mobile gallery. But I have older eyes and I appreciate the larger text and larger images. So that's how you adjust those. And of course, this type of gallery is completely adjustable as well on the page, just like the others. So let's go back to, I think we covered all of these. Yes, this is a certain type of, you know, if you go up here into the settings, where was that? theme. There it is, under general settings. I can't remember which other, okay, that's the alternating. And then we have mixed. That was the mixed, yes. That's the mixed gallery. So you can choose your gallery styles themes here, even once you get your element on the page. If you change your mind, you can go right to your settings and check out your images there. For example, let's do that. Let's just go ahead and let's go back to, let's go ahead and fill in some of our images. We'll take a look at it really quick. I'm gonna get rid of all of these except for the, we've got to keep two. So we're going to add those back in again to this gallery. The last two, we've got Dr. Martin and my beautiful Irish friend Colette. Now we're going to take this off. We're going to take this one off and save it. So now let's change these to the mixed. Oops. Here goes my alarm. All right. So you can see that I've got different sizes of images and it's going to look very, very strange here. Yeah. See what happens? That's why you have to know what kind of images and what sizes. Let's go ahead and try the matrix. Well, that's only four to a page. Oh, okay, get Colette in there. Let's see if we can make her big enough. What happens to the first page? All right, see, this is how you would have to have everything aligned properly. This will give you an idea of why you need to do that and play around with it first. Let's switch to the, let's see. Of course, one main is very interesting because it really reads them very differently. Because the images themselves are so different. So let's go right back to the matrix. We'll just leave it like that. Anyway, let's see. Is there anything else that we want to? Of course, once you find a gallery and you get it configured the way you like it, it's always a good idea to come down here and create a personal element, name it, and save it. Save it, because if you find something that works well, make note of the proportions of the images and then save it as a personal element. And all of this discovery then becomes something that you can put into action very quickly. So I'm going to go ahead and, well, to tell you the truth, I'm going to go ahead and get rid of the whole panel because this isn't exactly what I'm going to put on that page anyway. And we'll save it so I can come back to it. Now I'm going to stop sharing. I'll come over here. There we go. Anyway, that was a quick tour of all of the options that you have with galleries in Cheetah. So you have lots of design options. Let your mind really embrace that fact and understand. I would suggest, if you really want to learn how to use these elements, is create some graphics, create some different kinds, different styles of images, and then play around with it. Just spend 15 minutes a day or 15 minutes a week even, and play around with it. And you're going to find that your confidence will get bigger. If you allow yourself just to explore and try new ideas and try to see how you might use some of these elements differently, you're going to find yourself designing some really cool things and very quickly. And you'll really learn the software that way. So I really hope you enjoyed this really fast and furious tour of the different kinds of galleries we have in Cheetah. It's really a great option. And, you know, images are powerful. They're powerful ways of conveying meaning and value. So make use of these elements. They're really, really, really fun to play around with. Let's see. Well, I don't have anything else for you today. I'm going to play around with some galleries here later on tonight. I don't know. I'm really working on some projects that I'm excited to work on. So I'll stay focused and get it done. Other than that, I'll be back again tomorrow, and we will cover another aspect of how we can use Cheetah to build a vision board for ourselves, because it's so important to stay tuned in to your vision. And it's so powerful when you can actually see your vision regularly and keep it firmly implanted in your mind so you can focus on it. And I really am looking forward to using this. It may take me a while to get it all built, but I'm looking forward to using it. I think having a digital vision board is really an awesome way to take it with you wherever you go. So think about creating that vision board for yourself. Jump in and play around with me. Let's see what we can create. And I'll see you again tomorrow, same time. 3:00 Eastern Standard Time, right here in the Facebook group. And just have some fun and build something amazing with Builderall. Bye-bye now.